So we are looking for Mustafa Ahmed right now in relation to the shooting death that occurred at the bar on early Sunday morning. He is considered armed dangerous. Public shouldn't approach him. Somebody knows where this person is, and clearly we need to get him off the street before any more damage could occur. Mr. Ahmed has had several contacts with the Ottawa police. He's well known to us, and he spent most of his time in the Ottawa area.
And he's a gang member?
He is identified as a gang member as well.
Are you concerned about retribution? Is this what we're seeing in terms of these other shootings?
Clearly, that's our initial thoughts right now, where we're trying to determine if there's a connection from the homicide and the other shootings, and that's something we're very actively researching and searching right now with our investigators. Without getting into the details, I think that two members came in contact with each other and things happened, and one thing led to another, and like the chief has said, the prevalence of guns has always sort of been there, but the fact that they're using them now more than ever is what's really concerning, and obviously when you have members of the public in close proximity, that's what really concerns us.
The other three shootings we're currently investigating, and we're attempting to identify if there's any links to the initial homicide in the market that happened at 3:30 in the morning. So we're looking for another vehicle that's involved in one of the other shootings in the east end of the city. And our investigators from Major Crime and our gang unit are working actively at identifying who's responsible, if there are any linkages, and to ensure that those responsible are arrested. I'm here with the other chiefs from across Canada, and other large urban centres are seeing the same trend. And we've been talking about the trend that's been taking place here in Ottawa over the past couple of years as far as the increase of shootings, most of them, a good percentage of them gang-related, and the propensity and the willingness of gang members to use firearms quicker to resolve their issues. So we've seen that trend continue in our community. It's happening in Toronto and in other major urban centers. So we are working very hard to make sure that we have the capacity to investigate these crimes and to hold the offenders accountable, and working also with our other federal partners and provincial partners to deal with the flow of guns that are coming into our communities.